Well, the hotel union bosses addressing the latest move by the Atlantis Resort, which has to make some adjustments due to the global pandemic. LaDawn Davis has details.
A number of Atlantis employees, particularly in the food and beverage department, are once again being furloughed after Atlantis executives revealed that a hike in COVID-19 cases in the key markets and insufficient airlift were to blame for low occupancy levels in January. But the resort still remains open for business. President of the Bahamas Hotel Catering and Allied Workers Union, Darren Wood, says it's been an emotional roller coaster ride for Atlantis employees who were furloughed once before due to the COVID-19 pandemic, forcing the resort to shut its doors for several months.
Our industry is an industry that is driven by occupancy. So once occupancies dip, you will find that the employees will begin to work reduced days. There's a situation where they would go to working reduced days, and if it persists, they would then go to week on, week off.
While he could not say how long the furloughed exercise would last, Woods is asking that the process be carried out to allow affected employees time to catch themselves and provide for their families.
And there is no indication as to when the furlough is going to what they call it, is going to end. Again, taking into consideration that we are still under the emergency order, but whatever assistance programs are in place at the time is what they would be eligible for.
When asked if other hotel properties would take the same approach for its employees due to the low occupancy levels, Woods responded this way.
But we know that Ocean Club would have made some persons redundant last week. So we've not heard from any of the other properties. We're still waiting to hear from the Malia property, because they have not indicated when they are going to reopen. But in the midst of the rising cases, we don't know when that is going to be. And so we're just waiting to see and to hear.
In December, Atlantis reopened its doors, welcoming some 2,500 of its employees for its first phase. However, Wood says the union will respond to the communication of this latest furlough exercise in writing and are prepared to file a dispute if necessary. LaDawn Davis, ZNS Network News.